the challenges under the topic The Future of High Waters in the Venice Lagoon were chosen for two reasons. Obviously, TBA 21 Academy has found its home here in Ocean Space, but on the other hand, both topics that we addressed in the call, geoengineering on the one hand and nature-based solutions on the other hand, seemed at the time, and I think still are, really hot topics, no? Right. So for us, as we are continuously trying to build new knowledges around our relationship with the Venetian Lagoon here at Ocean Space or through Ocean Space in Venice, was really to explore these questions through two very distinct artistic practices.
I'm Leonor Serrano Rivas.
And I'm Diego Delas.
We are artists, architects, and researchers. And for the last 6 months, we've been working in Venice on a project called Breathings of the Moon.
For this first part of the project, which is called Breathings of the Moon Expedition, we present in a time-based performance in which it's going to be a storyteller that drags you into a boat. We have designed a canopy that hides you from the city, and inside the boat there's an instrument for imagination. We've been looking and researching into the tidal rhythms and movements within the canals of the city, and we've been mainly trying to translate those into this instrument and apparatus in which you are supposed to be looking at the relationship between the city and the waters in a different way.
What attracts us to this challenge was that already the call has had all the ingredients for a piece of storytelling. They were asking us for some solutions, and we, instead of doing that, we thought to look into Magia Naturalis, to try to look back into the 16th century, into a time before the scientific method was created, to find new ways of making questions into the lagoon. What we have learned during this challenge about the ocean and the lagoon resources is that on a moment where logic has failed, we have to place imagination in the center. So we've been talking to a lot of scientists and local agents, and we never really get the feeling to know what was the voice of the water. So that was the main question, and that was actually what led us to start researching on the rhythms, tides, what we call the breathings of the moon.
Somehow the project can contribute to gain a larger knowledge of the relationship between the city and the lagoon. Let's say that if we understand that the brain learns faster through analogy, and that we are bringing some sort of intimacy into this performative event, that fiction is going to let you widen your perception and widen your sensibility, and therefore learn in a travel from the micro to the micro.
We understand this project as a part of a larger one that is going to take the shape of potentially a film and a book. We really feel like we are just at the beginning of the research on tides, rhythms of water, that we would like to build a closer analogy to human body.